Here's Nancy Pelosi claiming to represent Rita and James, the oppressed masses, as it were. Have a listen.
It's not about me. It's about millions of Americans who can't put food on the table, who can't pay the rent.
And we represent them. And we represent them.
Getting by these long food lines.
We represent them.
I know you are.
We know them.
I'm just saying.
We represent them and we know them.
As we say.
We know them. We represent them.
So, Rita and James, I just want to show you how well Nancy Pelosi knows the people who can't put food on the table. Have a watch.
Chocolate, and then we have some other chocolate here.
See, yes. I've always felt a connection with you, and now I understand why.
Mm-hmm.
Since you've been isolating in your house, how much of your regular diet do you think is ice cream and candy?
Well, as much as possible. I enjoy it. I like it better than anything else. And I don't know why, but it seems to agree with me. I have a lot of energy. And we just got to restock the ice cream right for Easter Sunday because we were, shall we say, enjoying.
James, do you think that people who can't put food on the table in the United States believe that that woman represents them and she knows
them? No, and the first grab you played was really interesting because that's Wolf Blitzer from CNN, so hardly somebody from the right, going after Nancy Pelosi hard and deservedly for holding up stimulus relief that Donald Trump is proposing to help people keep food on the table. And Nancy Pelosi back home, she's got, look at that kitchen, those fridges are $20,000 a piece.
Exactly.
But what's remarkable is the fact that this woman who's been in politics for decades cannot cope with any difficult questioning. She has such an easy run throughout her career. She gets one tough question. You saw the meltdown there. She just can't cope.
Well, if only we could get her on Outsiders. You never know your luck.